had about 100 people who came to taste Georgian wine. We had just over 100 wines. And we had sommeliers, wine shop buyers, some of the national buyers, some fantastic broadcasters and press. We had two very full masterclasses on Crèverie myth busting, which was actually fantastic to show people what the Crèverie is really about. That it's not about oxidative wine, it's about textural but pristine wine.
There's a lot of very new things which are very interesting, especially for consumers, because they tend to be a little bit drenched to all this classic and feel kind of intimidating, whereas those wines are accessible and also something different.
I think Georgian wines are very exciting from various points of view. Firstly, the historic, if this is where wine first started, that's thrilling. Secondly, they've preserved some of those ways of making wine, and they are still making it like that, of course, with more modern hygiene and respect of technology that has happened since. But it does afford us a glimpse back into the where wines come from. And actually, these are styles of wines very often that are in tune with some of the modern palates, some of the people who are excited about wine, some younger people who are coming to wine, who love the flavour of wines made with the skin contact for the white wines that Georgian wines can provide. And they have splendid array of grape varieties. Grape varieties which are unique to them, which, they just give different, exciting flavours.
Sam introduced one of the wines that was a curry wine, but at the same time it was it was prepared through, I think, two different sort of stages where you did part of the winemaking process, fermentation in one, and then move to the other one to the rest. Comes out very concentrated, very interesting wine. So something that I found new and interesting, and a very interesting bridge between traditional and modern.
I think Georgian wine really has something different to offer the world. It's got this incredible history going back to the beginning of winemaking, but it's also got very much a 21st century feel to it. It's an emerging region which we could well do with on most good wineries should have some Georgian wine, I feel.
So there is a place for every type of Georgian wine, so whites, ambers, reds, and rosé and sparkling wines as well. And Georgia lives on wine. Georgian people are so proud of wine and winemaking. It's no other country, I think, in the world is so passionate about wine and winemaking.
What we all need to know is that there is white wine, and there is red, and then there is the amber/orange wines, which are really, really big enough, something that you really need to taste if you have not done so. And I'm an Asian, and I love Asian food, and I love Middle Eastern food as well. And what I discovered through the journey of tasting orange wines is that the food that can be paired with orange wines sort of caters to that Middle Eastern styles.
Varieties are very rare, not very common from the West palate, but I think are very good wines with food. Some are very complex, some native varieties are very citric, very specific for Asian food, for example, for spicy food. The other point is seafood, fish, strong fish, say, for example, salmon or haddock. I think some of the whites of these Georgian whites are very good with them.
But then there are the odd ones that you come across that just blow you away because they are so different and balanced and interesting. And there's just no way of describing them in one word. They're just very charitable.
I'm here because this is the one tasting of the year I would not miss. Georgian wine is the first new, I'm going to be really controversial here, it's the first new voice in wine since California.
They saw and told me that they saw what I think is exciting about Georgia, which is the pace of change and the diversity in the style of wines, the range of wines, the quality is really massively and thrillingly developing.